Welcome to this presentation on the Master of Organic Agriculture. My name is Anja Kuipers and I'm Program Director for this program, and I'm going to explain you about the background of this Master of Organic Agriculture. I will first tell a bit about the domain behind the program so that you get an idea of what it's all about. Then I will tell about the structure of the program and the professional perspective that you will have after having completed this master. Wageningen University offers high-quality education, and in the Keuzegids for Dutch universities, we have been ranking at the top one position for more than 15 years on a row. So that shows that we offer high-quality education. And as a student, this means that you will study in a unique and inspiring academic environment, where top-level research and innovation is combined with education. And that means that as a student, you can participate in this ongoing research already, for example, in your master thesis. The Master of Organic Agriculture is a broad master. It's much broader than only organic agriculture. It deals with also agroecology, sustainable food systems, and all kinds of variants of sustainable agriculture. In this way, it offers a broad interdisciplinary systems approach. And as a student, you will learn about diverse, resilient food production networks. The production and consumption are organized on a local and regional and global scale and are connected as such. And the program also focuses on the combination of academic theory and farmers' experiences in a participatory research approach. Food production can be seen at different global perspectives. For example, in Kenya, small-scale, low-input farming is the most common way of performing agriculture. It is quite contrasting to what's being done in Europe, where organic agriculture is certified and strongly controlled, resulting in a high-end product category of organic products in supermarkets, obviously related to higher prices. Agroecology and sustainable food systems has a strong focus on biodiversity. The conservation and improvement of biodiversity is an important aspect in agroecology. This also involves nutrient management, the efficient use of water, and care for biointeractions. On this slide, you can see a field with flower-rich field margins that attract natural pollinators, and this will improve the quality of the agriculture that is being performed in such a field. Another form of sustainable agriculture is agroforestry. This is a relatively new perspective in, for example, in Europe, but it is already common practice for much longer in for example, Asia and Africa. In agroforestry, trees and shrubs are combined with crops and pasture land. This fosters agricultural diversification, and it produces a wider range of products, including staple foods, fruits, nuts, wood products, and such a system improves resource use efficiency. Okay, these topics are integrated in the specializations of the Master of Organic Agriculture. I will explain a bit about the different specializations. Agroecology focuses on the sustainable production of crops and livestock. Sustainable food systems mainly deals with the social science perspective related to organic agriculture. It also includes a focus on globalization, on the development of international policy regarding sustainable agriculture and the required legislation. Then finally, the Master of Organic Agriculture offers a double degree, which is also called agroecology, which we offer in cooperation with ISERA Lyon in France. This program combines agroecology with a landscape perspective. In this double degree, the first year you will study at Wageningen University, then you will move to Lyon for the second year, and the thesis in this double degree program is co-supervised by both universities. when you are still in doubt on whether to choose organic agriculture as a master or the Master of Plant Sciences at Wageningen University, it is good to know where those two programs link. So, when you are in doubt, I would advise you to have a closer look at the composition and content of the Master Specialization Agroecology of the Master Organic Agriculture and compare that with the content of the Specialization Natural Resource Management in the Master of Plant Sciences. As all master's programs at Wageningen University, also the Master of Organic Agriculture is built out of four different elements. Basically you will start with the courses in the first year. Of the 120 credits in total, you will spend about 48 credits on courses. And this is combined in the first year with the academic master cluster, for which you will work on a consultancy project, for example, for a company in the organic agricultural sector. Then in the second year, you will do two more elements, a six-month master thesis, which is a research project usually done within Wageningen University, and a four-month internship, which focuses much more on the professional perspective. So what do you want to do after graduation? And this four-month internship is usually done outside the university. The courses at Wageningen University, so also in the Master of Organic Agriculture, offer a mix of teaching methods. In a typical course, you will have to spend about one-third of your time on self-study and two-thirds on teaching methods, education that is offered by lecturers from the university. And this involves, for example, lectures, tutorials, practicals, either in the lab or behind a computer to do modeling exercises. You will also have to work on assignments in a group to learn how to interact and cooperate, which is a necessary skill also for when you start to work. So in a typical course, you will find a mix of teaching methods. Also important to know, what do you need before you can be admitted to the Master of Organic Agriculture? Well, obviously you need to have completed a relevant bachelor degree for organic agriculture. This can be either in agriculture, but also in social sciences, as long as you have a link with the domain of organic agriculture. You need to have a grade point average of a minimum of 70% of what is maximum obtainable. So in the Netherlands, this would be a 7, but this is translated into your local grading scale. Because all masters at Wageningen University are taught in English, you need to prove that your English proficiency is okay. And you can do this by uploading an official proof of English fluency in your admission application. On this slide, you can see the professional perspective, so the type of jobs that graduates of the Master of Organic Agriculture start to work after graduation. And as you can see, most of the graduates start to work either in education and research or in non-governmental organizations. And in addition, there are other options, as you can see on this slide. If you want to hear more on the actual experiences of one of our graduates, I would like to refer you to this to the website of the Master of Organic Agriculture, where you can watch the story of Lara, who started to work as a policy advisor after completion of the Master of Organic Agriculture. On this slide, you can see that there are many jobs available for graduates of the Master of Organic Agriculture. I selected several recent vacancies, both in the Netherlands, but also international. And as you can see, there are many different options, for example, in education or in at the FAO or as a PhD student. And the content of these vacancies matches very well with the content of the Master of Organic Agriculture. This was what I wanted to share with you in this presentation. If you want to know more about the Master of Organic Agriculture, I would like to invite you to contact us on the online Masters Open Day for further information and to also have live discussions with staff and students of the program. It is also possible to send us an email through the specific mailbox of the Master of Organic Agriculture, or you can contact the student coach for organic agriculture for more personal student-to-student questions. This was what I wanted to share to you with you in this presentation. Thanks for your attention, and I'm looking forward to meeting you in Wageningen.